Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Subscribe to the channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms. You're on Instagram, Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook, Prince Miller Entertainment, Facebook group, Prince Miller Entertainment TV, and also on our Twitter handle, it's P Miller ENT. Welcome to another edition of our daily news on breaking news. Today is the 5th of July 2021. So guys, a few months ago, we talked about Marobas, Wakaroba Gateway, and this guy, $250,000. Just imagine, Wakaroba Chikoro, and this guy, 250k Yagaroa pass from Gateway High School. So, latest now regarding to that issue, police on Saturday arrested 7 dangerous robbers in separate incident under a special operation, during which one suspect was shot and killed in a shootout. Some of the robbers are understood to have been behind the March 28 raid at Gateway High School in Harare, where they made off with $200. The operation follows President Mnangagwa's stern warning to armed robbers countrywide that they would be brought to book. In a statement yesterday, National Police spokesperson, Assistant Commissioner Paul Nyati said the Zimbabwe Republic Police confirms the arrest of 7 dangerous and notorious armed robbers and the death of one robber after a shootout with police detectives in Harare on July 3, 2021. Police received information that one robbery gang leader, Godfrey Josie, was in Damafos, and a crack team raided the suspect, who bolted out of a room. He scuffled with the police officers and was shot on the left leg. A revolver loaded with 2 live rounds, 3 superpower explosive dynamites, and 4 fuse cables were recovered. Assistant Commissioner Nyati said Josie revealed that his accomplices were Richard Mtanga, Zude Zwashe Zuda, Peter Mushipe, Valentasa, Decide Rice, and the now deceased Benjamin Craig Musasa. He said Mtanga was raided in Unit O Chitungwiza, leading to the recovery of a Gateway vehicle, a Honda CRV, while Zuda was arrested at Kwadzana roundabout with a pistol and bullets. Police detectives followed Peter Mushipe in Stonebridge area, Harare, where the suspect tried to run away while armed with a 12-bore shotgun loaded with one live round. He was subsequently shot on the right leg, and live rounds of ammunition were recovered from his pockets. The fifth suspect, Valentine Mtasa, had a confrontation with police officers at Glenwood Park Epworth and was shot on the left hip, leading to the recovery of a 303 rifle with 3 rounds of ammunition. Rice said Assistant Commissioner Nyati was lured to Harare Drive in Glendale, where he arrived in the command of Benjamin Musasa. The two suspects suddenly fired some shots towards the police detectives. During the exchange of fire, Musasa was shot and arrested, while the ringleader, Rice, escaped. A revolver with erased serial numbers was recovered. Assistant Commissioner Nyati said the injured suspects were taken to Paranyatwa Hospital, where Musasa died on admission. He said they also arrested Juliet Gavaza, 37, after investigation revealed that she was married to Josie and had a house in Zengeza 5 Chungwiza, believed to have been brought from the proceedings of armed robberies. Police have secured all the transactional documents related to the house. The suspects are linked to 7 armed robbery cases, which include the one at Gateway High School on March 28, 2021, where $250,000 was stolen, and robbery in Mzari suburb Chinoi on 12 January 2021, where $60,000 was taken, said Assistant Commissioner Nyati. There is another robbery case at UZ Farm Compound on May 10, 2021, where $20,000 was stolen, and a recent robbery which occurred on 29 June 2021, when the suspects took $19,800 from a Beatrice farmer. He said they also established that Josie Mushipe and Mutasa, and the now deceased Musasa, were linked to several cases of armed robbery, and the arrest warrants against them. Mutasa is allegedly to have committed murder in Nembuziya Gokwe and was involved in an armed robbery case in Kadoma. Police reiterated the position of His Excellency President E.D. Mnangagwa that armed robbers will be dealt with decisively. Police urged the public to continue supplying information on all robbers so that the law may take its course, said Assistant Commissioner Nyati. So, as I want to say, big up to the police and it's for this investigations and arrest they did this past week. it seems as if they are working, although you know, I always say this kuti mapurisa edu are under resourced when it comes to zvokushandisa ndira, but they always manage to get the job done. So vanhu vari kusungwa, and these guys are dangerous people because vanenge vane pfuti, and I could tell you kuti the public is actually supplying information to the police, you know. Ndichaka tiri kuona vanhu vari kusungwa kudai, so because if the communities don't talk about this, kana macommunities akaramba akanyarara like here in South Africa, that's the reason why muchiona kuti crime rate here in SA is huge, because no one wants to talk to the police. Ukatoona kwayo uchotaura nemapurisa munomuka vanotokuuraya, because no one wants to provide information so that vanhu havasungwe. And again, here there are so many corrupt police officers, zvokuti vatidzongo want to provide information yacho iyoyo, then vatozopinda pamawani ndiwe zvakare. But in Zimbabwe, it's one of those things that our police, they always, you know, do their work, and again, the communities always provide information regarding to these people, because we don't need these people in our communities. And akadai soka anditombawade andingavaende kuchikurubi vanogara kuchikurubi koko, because to have them in our communities mawani chacho. And just imagine with mari yacho yavari kurobha yacho, imi mari yakawanda, $250,000 at Gateway High School, you know, imari yakawanda iyo, imari yekutoti maybe ingeri ima school fees kana tengeri levy, vanhu vabhadhara mari dzavo zvinonzi mari yakarova pasi. So it's a setback, you know, to the parents, to the school also. So people like this, we don't need them. And it seems like most of these guns are coming from South Africa. They are being smuggled into Zimbabwe, you know, and these guys are committing crime in footy things up in South Africa. So that's another problem again which is happening there. And saka the police will continue doing their work, and we say ngazvirambe zvakadaro, these guys, we don't need them in our communities. These guys, they need to be arrested, they need to be killed if possible, because vanhu vakadai soka vanokutoti vanotopinza mama one as a country. So guys, ngatitaure in the comment section. This is our daily news on breaking news on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Remember to follow us on all our social media platforms, Instagram, Facebook, and also our Facebook groups, Miller Entertainment TV. We're also available on Twitter, it's at PMillerENT. Remember guys to turn on the notification bell not to miss any of our new uploads. We upload each and every day here on your favorite channel, which is Prince Miller Entertainment TV. We welcome new subscribers who are watching us for the first time. Welcome to our channel. Welcome to daily news on breaking news. It comes to you each and every day, each and every hour, keeping you guys informed about what is happening in and around Zimbabwe. As long affects Mazimbo, we talk about it here. Big up to you, and salute to everybody who has been supporting us since day one. Big up to you guys, I love you. Salute. Thank you very much for watching and listening to our daily news on breaking news on Prince Miller Entertainment TV. Bless up.